In recent years, various generalization of Einstein metrics have been studied. One of them is the Ricci-Soliton. Pseudo-Riemannian manifold is called the Ricci-Soliton. If there exists some vector field x and some real constant lambda, for which the equation holds, where R is a Ricci tensor, G is a metric tensor. Lx from G is the Lie derivation from metric tensor. If our manifold is a homogeneous pseudo-Riemannian manifold, then Ricci-Soliton called homogeneous Ricci-Soliton. In Riemannian case, there are various information about Ricci-Soliton. For example, we have this compilation of results of many mathematicians. Any non-trivial, that is not Einstein, not product of Einstein and pseudo-Euclidean space, homogeneous Riemannian Ricci-Soliton must be non-compact, non-conformally flat, expanding, and non-gradient. But in a pseudo-Riemannian case, this theorem is not true. There are examples of compact, of conformally flat, of not expanding, and gradient, homogeneous, Ricci-Soliton, which are non-trivial. Our work was encouraged by part of this theorem about non-conformally flat. In pseudo-Riemannian case, there are some examples in small dimension of conformally flat material Ricci-Soliton, for example, in dimension 3 and 4. And our purpose is to investigate non-trivial conformally flat Ricci-Soliton on homogeneous spaces and in particular on Lie group. To do this, we consider an algebraic Ricci-Soliton. Lie group with left invariant pseudo-Riemannian metric is called algebraic Ricci-Soliton if this equation holds, where rho is a Ricci operator, lambda real constant, id identity operator, and d is some derivation in Lie algebra. Any algebraic Ricci-Soliton is homogeneous Ricci-Soliton, but otherwise true only in Riemannian case. In pseudo-Riemannian case, there are examples which are homogeneous Ricci-Soliton, but not algebraic. And we want to study non-trivial algebraic Ricci-Soliton on conformally flat metric Lie groups. Before I formulate the main result, we must be sure that this soliton exists. For example, we may consider this Lie algebra. Non-trivial Lie brackets and scalar products are represented on the slide. This metric Lie algebra is a semi-direct product. Epsilon I is plus minus 1, it's a signature of scalar product, and parameter alpha can be expressed through beta, and beta must be chosen such that this
is this a set of Riemannian?
No, pseudo-Riemannian, this scalar product.
Oh, yeah.
En is isotropic. N is pseudo-Riemannian, not Riemannian. Yes, A. This inequality must be held. This metric Lie algebra is non-trivial, conformally flat, algebraic, Ricci-Soliton. main result. Let G be n dimensional conformally flat metric Lie group, which is a non-trivial algebraic Ricci solid. Then the solution is steady. That is a constant lambda in algebraic Ricci solution. Soliton equation must be equal to zero, and the Ricci operator has a Segre type 1 dots 1 2 with only eigenvalue equal to zero. This means that in Jordan form of Ricci operator we have on main diagonal blocks 1 by 1, y 1 1, etc. and the last 2 by 2. And all eigenvalues is zero. In addition, G is a Ricci recurrent manifold. This means that covariant derivatives of Ricci tensor can be expressed through Ricci tensor and some one form omega, and omega from any vector from kernel of rho is zero. Let's consider metric Lie algebra and the Ricci operator of this metric Lie algebra has Segre type 1 dots 1 2. Then there exist bases in which the Ricci operator and metric tensor have the following forms. The Ricci operator have Jordan form and the metric tensor have this form where epsilon I is plus minus 1. Let's take this basis in our non-trivial algebraic Ricci non-trivial algebraic Ricci soliton which are conformally flat. In this basis we have omega from EI is equal to zero where I is not n, and omega from EN is equal to minus 1 multiplied by this structure constant. This shows that all covariant derivatives of Ricci tensor and so on Riemannian tensor, because of our Lie group is conformally flat, are expressed only through this structure constant. So if we take two conformally flat non-trivial algebraic Ricci soliton, then they are isometric if and only if this structure constant in some basis are equal to each other. Isometric means that in this basis Riemannian tensor and all covariant derivatives of it in one Lie algebra are equal to corresponding tensors in another. From work from papers 9 and 10 we have that metric Lie algebra is a metric if and only if corresponding connected and simply connected metric Lie group is a metric as pseudo-Riemannian manifold. This means that if we prescribe this constant and prescribe epsilon I, the prescribed scalar product, then we have only one non-trivial algebraic Ricci soliton, which are conformally flat. And so, if this inequality holds, then it is a metric to this example. Let's consider the sketch-up proof of these results. The first lemma: let G be an algebraic Ricci soliton. Then the Weyl tensor is harmonic tensor. This means that divergence of this tensor is zero if and only if this condition holds. The Weyl tensor is harmonic is a more weaker condition than conformally flat. In the start, we use this condition. To prove that, we use result what divergence of well, tensor is zero if and only if this difference between covariant derivatives of Ricci tensor is zero. Because of our Lie group is algebraic Ricci soliton, so we can express Ricci tensor through derivation D, and with using some basic formulas of pseudo-Riemannian geometry, we obtain this. Scalar product is not degenerate, so we obtain what we need. This lemma has various consequences, and one of them is lemma 2, which states that d squared from G is Abelian ideal of G. And with using first and second lemma, we obtain that for arbitrary vector x from the Lie algebra holds, rho d squared from x is zero. The proof of this lemma is quite simple. We need to consider Riemannian tensor from d squared x, y and z. From definition we have this, and all three summons is equal to zero because of lemma 1 and 2. And consider the definition of Ricci operator, we obtain is equal to zero. This equation gives us a restriction to eigenvalues of operator D, and so Ricci operator. We have two cases. If lambda is not equal to zero, then the operator D has a Segre type, this Segre type, with two eigenvalues, minus lambda and zero. And if lambda is equal to zero, then this Segre type with only eigenvalues equal to zero. From this statement, we obtain immediately that if Ricci operator is diagonal in some basis, then Ricci soliton is trivial. And for example, in Riemannian case, Ricci operator always diagonal in some basis. So in Riemannian case, all this soliton is trivial. And now let's consider case lambda is not equal to zero. Let's take two vectors x and y, not in kernel, such that dx and dy is linearly independent. And from one hand we have Riemannian tensor from dx dy and dx is equal to zero, but from the other hand we can calculate Riemannian tensor through the Ricci tensor and obtain that it's not zero. This contradiction shows that we cannot choose some of these vectors, and so dimension of dg is 1, or Ricci operator is diagonal. These arguments, similar arguments may be applied to in other cases, and we obtain the main theory. In conclusion, I want to say that there are some examples of conformally flat, non-trivial homogeneous Ricci soliton, which are not algebraic Ricci soliton. So our next step will be consider conformally flat, non-trivial, homogeneous Ricci soliton. And all our results from the beginning, from this lemma and to this statement is true if the well tensor is only harmonic, not well tensor is equal, only divergence of it is equal to zero. So we can consider non-trivial algebraic Ricci soliton with harmonic well tensor in the future. That's all. Thank you for attention.
Is there any question?
So, your definition of algebraic, Richard Soliton is purely algebraic. On the other hand, usual, at least, definition of conformally flat and also the covariant derivative suggests that this is defined at least locally. So, there is algebraic condition for...
algebraic condition for conformally flatness?
Yeah.
We use a condition that the well tensor is equal to zero. It's locally conformally flatness.
Well, you suggest that not in one point, but locally?
Yes, locally only group.
And the same covariant derivative you consider?
Yes.
Any other questions? Okay, let's thank the speaker again.